So, continuing with the lifespan. So, Enki and Marduk worked together on the lifespan, and they found that these beings are able to live up to 500 to 700 years, Earth time. Now, because of everything becoming like manifested, they realized that they're able to equate time. This was done by Marduk, of course. Marduk realized that everything has an equation to it. And he realized that if you look at the equations in terms of the physical human form vessel and the systems within, including the being, if he equates everything in totality, he says 700 years. But he said, in terms of if I look at what it is we're wanting to do, getting millions and billions of people here to prepare a certain placement and design for you, in this planet, on this planet as you, there will be a lifespan later of no more than 40, 50 years old, maybe 60, possibly 60, no older, occasionally maybe 80. But the oldest lifespan would be around 40, 50. And that was then already, before anything was put into place. He was able to do that because, remember now, nature, the animals, the human form, as the systems inside it, was all mathematical, equated space-time continuum. Because everything became compressed and manifested, and that's why he was able to equate that. So, that's how lifespan was determined. So they said 700 years is cool. They're fine with that. In a few, maybe billions of years, thousands of years, 30, 40 years will be reached, and that's okay. We'll deal with it when it comes. For now, all we want is these human forms on this planet, perfect. The dimensional placement is in place. And that's all we need for now. So first, let's get all of existence here. So that's what they did. First, the Martians were the more like brutal ones, you know. They actually went and captured dimensional beings. They went to planets. Now these races are huge. The Anunnaki, the Martians, the Syrians, and the Serpents were the four biggest, largest races in existence. They were really extensive. The others were more the little contained profound ones. And you know, they had many different methods. They had like these sound bracelet things that was placed here. See, everyone believed during that time that it was possible to be captured because they didn't know of anything else. They didn't know of enslavement or control or anything that would ever maybe even consider doing this. It didn't exist in them. So therefore it was quite simple to do that what was necessary to be done. So it was simple. They captured them and placed them into this dimension. Or the Serpents, the Syrians were quite a sly, manipulative race. They were your suave, like, sweet talk race, but very, very evil, I'd say. Their posture, their voice, their standing, their presentation, everything was like, you become mesmerized by their voice, by their company. And so they also assisted with planets capturing dimensional beings, saying to them, we have got a proposition. We see your planet is currently depleting and you don't know why. You need a place to stay, right? Yes. Okay, come to our planet. We've got a place for you. So they said, okay. See, by then everyone trusted everyone to a certain extent. Certain extent. From the perspective of, I'm speaking of this trust as, they were naive in their not considering what is possible in existence because they couldn't find it inside themselves. Which is dangerous. Very dangerous. So separation then already existed. And soon, it took a few. Let's say about 15 Earth years it took to get all of existence here, quite a while. to make sure everyone's here. But first, everyone was placed into this dimension. Now, this dimension was the illusion of infinity. The infinity, as it is, as who we are, hasn't been experienced by anyone on Earth yet. I'm sorry to say, but even the dimensions. Because infinity exists as and in human beings. But now you're probably asking, but how? I'm a system. I'll explain. Just hold on. And so everyone was placed into this dimension around Earth. Now, Anu had already prepared the physical form. Now we get to the Adam and Eve story. Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve, in terms of... Okay, I'll continue with Adam and Eve in my next interview. Thank you very much.